Jesus is Lord. And he was such a nice Jewish boy. Jesus changed my life. And he's still in the life-changing business.
As Paul said, the love of Christ compels me.
You know, Randy, I think most people don't realize how much darkness there is in the world.
It can't be just coming to church and getting pumped up with the... You and I are all going to have something of faith in us by which we stand.
Jesus died to save sinners, and you are a sinner.
Well, welcome once again to Crosstalk. I'm Josh Weiss. And if you were with us last week, you got to meet a new friend, Jonathan Feldstein from Heart to Heart Ministries. And Jonathan is here with us again this morning. And I'm grateful that you joined us. And Jonathan, we talked last week about your organization. You guys serve as the primary EMS for the nation of Israel, the only EMS
That's
for
right.
the nation of Israel.
That's right.
You guys are kind of like the one-stop shop. You need blood? Come to you guys. You need an ambulance? Call you guys up. You are the 911 of Israel.
That's correct.
And we all know that conflict is no stranger to Israel. And we also know that people want to help Israel, at least Christians, many times if they're reading their scriptures, they want to help Israel. I came into contact with you through a mutual friend, and when I started doing some research, I saw some of your articles. You often write as a journalist for Charisma Magazine.
That's right.
Which, that's a little bit of a unique situation. You've got an Orthodox Jew writing for a Charisma Magazine, being interviewed by a Messianic believer here. So nice to meet you.
Some might say, what's wrong with this picture? I like to say, what's right with this picture?
Yeah, you know, I think that there's more that can be done with these types of relationships.
Yes.
We want the same thing. We want to bless Israel. We want to see Israel healthy. And right now, things are tense. We read the scripture, and we say it often, and people hear it often. I will bless those that bless you and curse those that curse you, referencing Israel.
Correct.
And it's one of those scriptures that, what does that look like when it's on the ground? I mean, I want to bless those that bless you. Okay, I speak a blessing over Israel? I mean, come on, how can I really bless Israel? What are some tangible ways that our audience can bless Israel? Speaking as a Orthodox Jew living in Israel,
right.
What are some tangible ways that we can bless Israel?
Well, there are many, and I appreciated how last episode you emphasized prayer, because prayer is something that we all can do, must do, and I think that is a tremendous way of blessing Israel, because God will answer our prayers. God is answering mm-hmm. our prayers. Maybe not all of them. Maybe not all of them in the way that we are asking, but God's got our back, and so we need to remind him that we know that and we care for that. As far as other ways that are physical, tangible, because sometimes people aren't seeing the answers of those prayers necessarily and feel that they want to do something more tangible, more direct, where you see a cause and effect. So as you mentioned, I'm running a organization called Heart to Heart. We support Israel's National Blood Bank and ambulance service. We're partnering with all kinds of ministries all over the country to join us to take Heart to Heart as their project to bless Israel in any way possible. And it's interesting and appropriate. You mentioned Genesis 12:3 because I keep getting testimonies from people who are partners sharing with me how, since partnering with us, since asking their church, for example, to donate everyone to donate a dollar a week, that they've been blessed in ways that are so tangible. In fact, it's just a funny story about the reciprocity of that blessing. There's a gentleman who's the sales manager at a Toyota dealer in North Carolina, and he took Heart to Heart to his Toyota dealership, which initially I thought was kind of weird, maybe selling Girl Scout cookies or doing a 10K race, but actually promoting Heart to Heart in his Toyota dealership. I met him several months after he started doing it, and he shared with me that in the month that they started promoting Heart to Heart, they had the highest sales ever. There's no coincidence involved in that. And to not just to bless, but be blessed reciprocally, it's just an incredible opportunity. So heart to heart through ambulance, through the ambulance services. We've had ministries step up to the plate to donate ambulances in those last 10, 12 years. So the lifespan of the saving of thousands of lives, not just through a unit of blood, which can be hundreds of lives. There are many ways to bless the land. I'm working with a ministry that is involved with pruning and collecting the grapes from vineyards in Judea and Samaria, which is a fulfillment of biblical prophecy. The fruit of the land, and to be able to be there to actually to help the farmers, but to physically, tangibly touch these grapes and know that you're participating, you're a partner with God in the prophecy of what's going on. It's awesome. It's not just fruit. It's like a bite of prophecy in every little grape. It's incredible. Trees are necessary, imported for people who have more of a environmental interest. Israel's the only place in the world that ended up with more trees at the end of the 20th century than fewer trees. Instead of chopping them down, we've been building them. We've been planting the land. We've been reclaiming the land, even making the desert bloom. So there are many ways to participate on that level. And there are any number of humanitarian ways where people just are in need. We're people. We've had rockets in our neighborhood. And I think that there's going to be long-term counseling needs for a generation of Israeli kids who now are in rocket fire for the first time. Two-thirds of our population is in range from the rockets that have been fired from Gaza. And I see through my own children the trauma that's inflicted upon them. And I wonder rhetorically, is this just what it means to be an Israeli? And we're just going to live with it and absorb it into our DNA? Or do we need to be counseled and helped to overcome it and then deal with it the next time it happens? Because I don't believe that it's done.
I've often tried to put myself in that position and imagine what life would be like myself. Yeah. As an individual, as a husband, right. As a father, as a business owner, as a pastor. There's many times that I think through, and you can't plan for that type of life. Like, you can't just say, this is how I'll be if, this is how I'll respond when. And until you get into that situation and you find yourself being forced to come to grips with what that reality right. looks like. And so it makes those who bless Israel all that more important and meaningful to those in Israel.
Oh, yes, indeed.
It's a sign of solidarity. It's a sign of, we stand with you.
That's right.
We don't just, it's not just a blessing because I want to bless somebody with a $5 bill.
Correct.
It's not just stopping by somebody who's homeless on the street and offering them a bag of food. It's more than that. It's not just the blessing. It's all of the symbolism that encompasses that blessing, that goes with that blessing, that says, you and I, we're brothers.
That's right.
You and I, we stand together. I support you. I stand with you. I pray with you. And it's not just an empty thing to make me feel good about my gift. It's because we're together in this.
It means a tremendous amount, and it's been very hard for me to be away from home this past week and a half. Traveling, one of the blessings I receive, and I don't use that lightly, because not just because we're talking about it, but it's sincere. I have the privilege of traveling across America and working with Christians and people who support Israel, and being a Jew, you're a lightning rod for things that aren't so good. We're experiencing that in Israel right now. There's a rise of anti-Semitism, especially in Europe, also here in the States. But I am the lightning rod for an uncontrollable amount of love and blessing that I try to source back to my family and friends and say, no, look, these people are with us. There are millions of people who are standing with us. And even if my posting two sentences on Facebook derives five dozen likes of my friends in Israel who get it, who feel it for a fleeting moment, it is a blessing. And it's so terribly important.
I want to touch base on that aspect of how people can bless when we come back, about social media and just being intentional about supporting Israel. Stick with us. We've got more with Jonathan Feldstein, and you won't regret it.